Good morning, everyone. My name is Mahek, a student of class 9th EDICA studying in DC Model Senior Secondary School. Today, I'm going to talk about the multidisciplinary project titled Technology and Humans. But before that, I would like to discuss the meaning of the word multidisciplinary itself. Well, it's a kind of approach that primarily focuses on the different viewpoints and the diverse perspectives they bring along with them to illustrate a theme, topic or an issue. Hence, the project provides you in-depth understanding of the given topic. It teaches you perseverance, that is, learning from failures and starting over again from scratch, and also it gives you a platform to show your creativity. Coming to the topic, that is, technology and humans. Well, Matt Mullenweg, a social media entrepreneur, once said that technology is at its best when it brings people together. Hence, understanding the relationship between technology and humans is the key to responsible development and accepting all the future possibilities in every field, that is mobility, transportation, education, learning, or be it any, would be really beneficial. So now, let's have a look. The project is titled Technology and Humans. This page over here shows the table of contents. Coming to science, it shows about ventilators, that how back in the 16th century, a physician, Andreas Vesalius, discovered this process. The modern day ventilator was invented by Forrest Burt, an American aviator, in 1958. This is the working of the ventilator, that how it is used in hospitals and ambulances. Though it is a life-saving invention, it carries potential risk. It can cause many diseases including pneumonia and alveolar damage. According to WHO, 80% of the patients suffering from coronavirus can recover, but severe cases need the uses of ventilators. This is the diagram that shows the working of a ventilator, that how the air flows in and flows out into the patient's system. Coming to social science, it shows some common disasters faced by our country, India, including the railway accidents, Kerala floods, cyclones, and Vijayawada fires. Where do they usually occur? In Maharashtra, West Bengal, Rajasthan, Karnataka are some of the states which are prone to natural disasters. Now, the two technologies that can help us in discovering and predicting natural disasters are fractals and seismometers. Areas prone to natural disasters. If we come to this map, we can see that how different natural disasters occur in different countries depending on their locations. Mathematics. This histogram shows the internet users in India in the last 5 years, and we can discover a significant increase in the number over here. The modern age of internet users in India is 12 plus years. That shows that most users are youth. Now, this diary entry over here shows my experience during the lockdown, that what new things I discovered and how technology came to our rescue when the schools were closed. This is a conversation between a teacher and a robot, that how the robot misunderstood the orders and did malfunctioning. Hindi. This shows the emotions of an old lady whose son has died recently, and now due to the lockdown, how she is facing a lot of difficulties both financially and emotionally. Punjabi. This essay shows the benefits of having technology in our day-to-day life and how it has changed our life to a great extent. Wally art over here shows that how with the use of technology, even art has changed. Back in the times when the people used to live in caves, they used to draw such arts. Thank you.